Hey guys, welcome back to another Commander Cook 3 Kings Wrath video commentary. We have another game here for you today between two great players. But first, before we jump into it, you've probably all seen it on game replays, a new tournament, the Inca Open, which has something like an $800 prize, and we've already got like about 40 people signed up. They're only accepting 32. It's going to be a group stages thing. More details to come. There will be a website, but I'll be advertising it here on my channel. I'll be making sure to mention it at the start of most of my videos. But that's going to be awesome. Again, we've got like Bonus Root and Technique have come back for this one here. There's a full range of players, all the good guys. Wookiebert, Steve Nash, Master Leaf, Unleashed UA, Death Sentence, myself, Green Zero, will all be playing in this tournament. This is going to be an amazing tournament. I could make an entire video about it, but we're going to jump into this game here now until that website gets launched, which will host the tournament. Hopefully they don't all get banned. But anyway, we have Five Pace, aka Space, and Unleashed UA playing on Torment Rift here. So yeah, Torment Rift, what can I say? It's obviously the best map of all time, but on the left-hand side, did not even check the colors. It is gonna be Unleashed UA trying to get his skill back because he's always been around. Like it's not as if he's only coming back for this tournament. He's been around there, but he's been a little bit low key. He's going for one engineer, a second engineer on the cards. Meanwhile, Fire Pace, aka Space, is over here. He's playing as Skryn Vanilla. Yes, that's right. 2-3 disintegrators. So he's using slow desints. He's like, hey, Unleashed, I'm going to use slow desints. It does throw people off. You can obviously, if you spot the disintegrators, you can select them and move your mouse over here. And it doesn't show the advanced articulator upgrade because it says explodes when crushed, and it would have another one below it saying upgrades advanced articulators, but the other player can see that by selecting them. So Unleash is going to know their slow descents, and when you see slow descents very far in advance, you're very comfortable. Wow, is he going for, oh, he's going for both the bottom spikes. He's already secured his main. He's even got scouts just chilling here as well. Like he's anticipating that this could be a possibility. He's already securing the bottom area. Look at that, scouts intercepting. He will try to engage. They're not going to work. He's got the garrison there. One squad is garrisoned. He really could just put the second squad in there, I think. Maybe he wants to try to draw fire. He is going to start engaging now, and this is not good for Space. What can I say about Space here? He's a pretty good player. He's obviously not top tier or anything like that. He'd just be a good, reasonable player. Unleashed UA, I would have think, would have an edge in this game here just because he's got the experience, even though he's out of practice, so could be close. Look at that, even sniping down the buzzer and killing everything. Space really shouldn't have done that. He really shouldn't have engaged on a garrison. He only got half of its health down. Unleashed will secure both the bottom spikes. He built a lot of rifleman squads though. That's the thing, he built a lot. He built like about six of them. Now that's a lot of money because GDI rifles, they're $300 each at the start of the game. That's really gonna hurt you, especially when you have two engineers. Obviously it's paying dividends now, but you can see he hasn't actually got his second refinery. He's actually building a harvest and going to the Tiberium, the blue Tiberium field. So he's got two in his main and a third. Another one is coming out now. So he's finally got the sound. He's trying to snipe that buzzer swarm down with the harvester. And Space does somewhat see it. He is going to try to move away, but no, there's way too many harvesters. You shouldn't really drive into the harvester line when you're playing a GDI as Skryn. Those guns on the harvesters will take out a buzzer pretty quickly. But yeah, he's going to secure blue tier. I'm pretty sure Space isn't aware of it. Space actually going for blue Tiberium, sending a harvester that's got about 40% of its tank already full. Probably not the best idea. You need to get the most off your return. Probably lucky because Unleash is going to have gathered most of the blue crystal anyway, so he probably wouldn't have got a full load of blue Tiberium. Unleashed is going to basically take just about everything here. He's going to evac. His tank is about 95% full there. There's a little squeeze left of Space, but he's not going to attempt to stick around. He wants to get his harvester away. These Seeker tanks are doing a fair bit of damage. That Seeker tank has taken a reasonable amount of damage. Unleashed should be able to slow this down. There's actually no more Pitbulls. Oh my god, there's only one Pitbull. Are you serious? Unleashed UA is going to lose his blue tip harvester here. That's very unfortunate. He really could have defended that. I'm not sure why he didn't. He's not even building anything from his war factory there. And we do have a battle marker over here. It's just scouts, so he's not doing anything crazy. But yeah, that's just unfortunate. All that blue Tiberium will never be harvested because it's only dropping a tiny crystal of green. We have a crane. Okay, there you go. So there is a crane build over here. These Seeker tanks are now going to find this harvester. Watchtowers, I mean, Seekers are pretty vulnerable to gun damage. You can see that even a watchtower with no APM can actually do a fair bit. It is raining. I'm not sure if you guys can hear that. It's raining pretty heavily outside. That's actually, wow, that's really heavy. Okay. But hopefully that's not echoing too much in the mic there, because Unleashed doing a good job microing this around. He might be able to save this, and I think, yeah, he should be able to save it. It's going to take a lot of unnecessary damage, but he will be able to retain that one there. Unleashed UA going for a crane so early on, just not, he really tried to eco hard those Seeker tanks, which is very difficult for him to clean up. And you can see that Space here now has the tier 2. He's building out some more Seeker tanks here. Again, Unleash does have 3 Spike, so there you go, he does have 3 Spike. Space going back for more Blue Tiberium. There's really no Blue Tiberium left though, so that's not really beneficial. If you're going to get Blue Tib by leeching, you really got to put your Harvester on a control group. This Lightning Spike might actually be able to finish that Harvester. No, Unleash is on point, gets it behind the Refinery, and the line of sight is now blocked. Those two towers are still there, but unfortunately, low power mode. The Harvester can't really do too much. He's probably just going to wait for that to be destroyed. A few pit bulls up here again. Unleash a little bit rusty by the looks of things, but this match, I probably should have mentioned it, has got about 10 wubs, which is really high for this day and age, so I'm expecting some magic to happen in this game here. Starting to attack the other Harvester there. We've got APM on the way. We've got a battle marker in the main. It's just a buzzer scout, just seeing what's what over there. These towers having a tough time dislodging this lightning spike because it's pretty resistant to the gun type weaponry. Third tower will come down now. He could use the Orca Strike to finish that. The Orca Strike does a lot of damage against a fixed target, especially when he can't move it. So he's actually in trouble losing this Harvester here. There's a battle marker out there. I'm pretty sure it's just scouts. Is he actually going to be able to save this? I think he's going to lose this Harvester. He's not even microing it away. Oh my God. Clutch. Clutch save. Unleash probably not even aware. Look at that Harvester. One shot from dying. But that was pretty insane. This other Harvester now getting repairs. I think he's spotted it. Yeah, he has. He's spotted it. He's actually going to get it some repairs because it's really not cost effective to leave that there. Because it's harvesting so slowly when it's that heavily damaged. We do have attenuated force fields here for Space, and Bloodhound's coming in as well. So APM is done these, even with attenuated force fields. Oh, he's actually got shard launchers. Oh, wow, he's got a tech center and shard launchers, so this could change the deal. He's going to have very powerful Seeker tanks. You don't see this combination very often just because Skryn tends to go for other alternatives, but since this game started out a bit quirky, all of a sudden they're actually... they're actually pretty decent here. Again, if you can get, if you are late game and you have these, they can really shut down certain types of play, like stealth tank play and light vehicle play. Especially what Unleash is doing, these APC pitbull are not going to be terribly effective against shielded shard launcher seek. It's pretty much just a side effect. You usually get this upgrade to get your double A weapons to have shard on them. He's getting a bit overwhelmed here. He's taking down quite a number of units, but Unleashed is really pushing with heavy pitbull APC. So that's his composition of choice here. He's going to use it to lose. If you can see how powerful the Seekers, the shard launchers are on the Seekers, able to pop these pitbulls almost in one single, or basically in one volley. The APCs will be a bit of a different story here. But we'll have to see what Space is going to do. He's making a move for the center field. He kind of needs some tripods, and here comes two tripods. They do not have the force field generators because he spent time getting shard upgrade. Maybe he thought Unleash was going to go for... Phase comes in. Nice work there. Maybe he thought he was going to go for Firehorse because shards is really good against protecting your base. We have a stasis chamber come down, which is probably for the actual ability itself and not any particular tech path here. He's trying to crush with these tripods. He's forcing Unleash around. Unleash could just focus fire on that stasis chamber and move if he has them on aggressive stance, which he does. And he's actually going to pop it. So there you go. He pops it down. I'm not sure if he actually used the ability. I didn't see it go off anywhere on the map. I mean, there's not much point using it anywhere but this area here. One of these tripods is unfazed, so it is firing back. And of course, he does have force field generators. So that upgrade is actually done. So yeah, Space actually been macroing pretty heavily behind this. He's doing pretty good job here. Does he have multiple drone ships? No, he does not. Yeah, I think he thought it was maybe Firehawks or something. That's why he's actually got the shard upgrade. It was probably for the double A turrets, which it usually is. Unfortunately, that shadow tank was reverse moving in the wrong direction. And photon cannon's the only tier 2 base defense worth actually building. And the fact they get a shard upgrade, we've seen some multi-MCV Skryns before spamming them just because they're with shards, they're so powerful, and it's basically like a cheap obelisk, you know. It's so good, but you do need to get pretty far into the game to actually get that happening. These tripods now are just going to kite around. That Marv is almost done, and he's actually going to run forward. Is he going to try to EMP this? I think maybe he forgot that in the selection, that's why it's running forward. He's going to pull back now, but this Marv should complete very shortly. Unleash having a bit of money problems there. Let's have a look at his main over here. No, he's got plenty of harvesters there. He's obviously investing in a lot of tech paths at the same time. Stasis comes down. That's going to delay the Marv. Oh, that ability, you really want to use that in a combat situation, not to just slow down his build. I mean, it didn't cancel anything. It's only paused the Marv. I mean, I don't know. He's actually got railguns. Wow. Railguns is done, and here we go. He's got these shard launchers here, and he should be able to pick off this one Sonic Emitter. And look at that. Unleash being forced to put down Guardians because he couldn't build Sonic Emitter as well as... is he going to snipe that? Oh my god, he got pretty close, but no, the Marv is going to come out. He sells it as well to get the Zone Trooper squad, not re-garrisoning that Zone Trooper squad just yet. Space does have does have a few of these shard launches here. Don't want to put them too close together. They will take splash damage, maybe, possibly. Maybe only the main cannon's going to take splash damage. And this Marv is actually... There's a lot of firepower here. And the Marv got a little bit too anxious. And he's going to be actually snipe this one down. That's going to be a really easy pickup of the Marv. I think Unleash completely underestimated that situation there. The Marv will fall. More Railgun Guardians coming down, because why the hell not? It's something you don't see very often. He's got Railguns, so it's just a cheap... really cheap base defense. They're only $1,200 and they can actually be repaired. But now all of a sudden Unleash has this tier 1 slash tier 2 army, and there's even a Mammoth Tank in there, which is just starting to push through his base. There's actually a Mammoth Tank up there as well, and these tripods. Oh no, my god, Space is in so much trouble right now. He's in so much trouble. These tripods can't really fight this. They're taking a lot of damage. He does pop one of the Mammoth Tanks, but there's more Mammoth Tanks here. The drone ship is very close to going down. Unleash does change targets at the last moment. Probably a bad idea, but he will drop it regardless. Heroic Rifleman Squad. Okay, another Mammoth Tank will fall. He's actually doing a good job. He's only lost one tripod, so the focus fire was not there. But now there's Zone Troopers here, and we want to know what Master League says about Zone Troopers. They are really good against Skrin on the ground, which is really surprising. But yeah. The phase will come off, and not able to crush those shatterers. A bit sneaky, yeah, he gets one then. But he only lost one tripod. The others are all phased, and they should all be able to escape. So Unleash got torn up a bit, but he just ripped out Space's heart. That was the problem here, and it's gonna chill just for a little bit here, just so these guys can regroup their forces. Space probably gonna have to invest in some anti-infantry. He does have another drone platform, so I'm assuming he did have two of those there. A few harvesters rallied down here, obviously away from danger. Now he's forgotten about those guys. Blue type room is being harvested. Space does have two loads of it right there. That's gonna be very nice. That's a lot of money. That's basically, what is that? It's like $5,600 in those two harvesters. That's that's pretty steep. That's another two tripods just about. So. He's going to be looking for that. And attenuated force fields, of course, affecting gunwalkers. He's going to have them to be able to clean up the infantry. Zone troopers, they can overwhelm some gunwalkers, but if there's a lot of them, I mean, there doesn't even really have to be a lot of them. It just has to be a small group, and the zone troopers won't be able to clean them up, because the zone troopers will die pretty quickly to their gun type damage. Constructing these zone troopers on the ground, no scanner packs or power packs here. But again, it's something that we have identified, that zone troopers just by themselves on the ground are good against certain screen compositions. It can be difficult for them. The buzzer swarm is their only saving grace, and it barely ever works in the late game just because there's so much firepower. The buzzers usually get cleaned up quite quickly. There's quite a number of zone trooper squads here. That harvester unnecessarily taking damage out there. Unleash will not be pulling that one back, unfortunately. He pulls the other one back there, or he pulls it to the side. What you can do, you can always order it to harvest in Tiberium, which is in a safer part of the field. Probably not so much of a thing here, because the whole field is somewhat under threat right now. That harvester there taking damage, some of those predator tanks pulling back. Unleash not able to rally his defense correctly here. He's still taking a few harvester losses. That harvester now being attacked, and the zone troopers will jump jet all together. They are prime for a buzzer swarm, but you really don't want them there. You want to spread them out in a formation. That's the way to do it. This harvester here unnecessarily taking damage, and it will go down. Another harvester Unleash, unfortunately, just bleeding out harvesters here. I'm not sure. I can't see anything else happening on the map. There's no other battle markers, so this is where the engagement is happening. Torment Rift pretty famous sometimes for getting stalemates like this. But there's no artillery for Unleash. There's no juggernauts. He's still going with rail weaponry just because the tripods could just crash through his front door. And juggernauts will not be able to stop that. Again, he's just spending all his time getting these rail weapons now. And Space is doing a great job. He's poking forward, destroying stuff, and then pulling back and taking virtually no damage in the process. He's doing a fantastic job. And he's got a gravity stabilizer here as well, which means Devastator warships are on his mind, and he can then siege from the air. And Unleash has absolutely zero AA, which means he's going to have to transition hard to counter that. And it's just going to put more strain on his micro and more strain on his economy, which is already quite low. He does have a nice defensive line. Will snipe a harvester down there. That's quite good. But again, neither side really eager to really engage in here. Space has just cleared all the harvesters off and all the frontal defenses. So he's just fine to just chill back here. That harvester there, he will have to evac out. Turns around, grabbing the Christie. That's what I'm saying. He's grabbing Christie, which is outside of the range of the Sonic Emitter, allowing him to continue to harvest. But unfortunately, these Mammoth Tanks, oh my god, they completely dominated that. And Unleash has a flank to the top there. Will he go to the bottom? Not 100% sure. He's going to snipe down maybe another Harvester. He will score another Harvester kill. There's disintegrated squads here, but to be honest, these rail weapons can actually destroy them because there's not enough of them to overwhelm the Mammoth Tanks there. And once again, the Sonic Emitter coming in and doing a fair chunk of damage. That Harvester, one more shot from that Photon Cannon. And see you later, Harvester. That Harvester is down. Unnecessary loss of Harvesters here. Where are the Zone Troopers? They're over here. They've actually been thrashed pretty heavily. One Mammoth Tank gets left behind, and Space will make him pay for that. Space is actually pushing Unleash back. Unleash has got no response to this now. He's got a very powerful armored force, but where's he going with these Mammoth Tanks? I think that might have been an issue. And here come the Devastators, and I think once he sees this, he invested in two refineries here as well. Really hasn't harvested. Look at how few Tiberium crystals there are missing there. Most of those were probably just destroyed in the combat as well. Space actually able to harvest a fair chunk, but again, some of that would have been destroyed as well. A lot of people underestimate just how much Tiberium actually gets destroyed when people are fighting in it. There are often times where you'll push someone off a base and you'll have basically wiped out most of the field just through splash damage Tiberium crystals. So you can see it's got health. This Tiberium crystal is damaged. The rest of it seems to be in pretty good nick. Some of it's a little bit damaged here and there. There's a damaged crystal, so that's how it rolls. Battle marker down here. Unleashed is looking to circumvent this. His MCV, I believe, is evac. Where is his MCV? Yeah, it's down here. He's gone to the bottom spike. Doesn't really need to be there because he kind of has these spikes already. I'm not sure if he's picked up on that. He could harvest this blue Tiberium, but now Space is able to harvest this. Space is looking like he's in a nice... And look at this. He's going to come around the rift, and he's going to fight Unleashed. Where is Unleashed's army? His armor is falling back. I don't know where it's going. Where are the Mammoth Tanks? They need to be here. The Mammoth Tanks are, oh my god, they're so far out of position. They could do a lot of damage. Space is probably not aware that they're there. But, oh man, Hammerhead transition. Zone heads. Are these all zone heads? Oh my god, look at the zone heads. Space does. There's even grenades in there. He's got zone troopers in most of these. Most of them. There's a few empty ones and there's grenades, but there's enough zone troopers in here. And all of a sudden, he has to phase. Nice phase there. One tripod will be left behind. Meanwhile, he's engaging up here. He should be able to take out that tech center, no worries. He has managed to destroy the one tripod. He can't get the rest of them. He might as well fire at the disintegrates, which he is doing. The Mammoth Tank circumventing the tech center. They could take that out. Unleash is obviously divided in what he's actually doing here. That Devastator warship is veteran and it's not being shot down. Meanwhile, these tanks are moving through here. Look, some power plants, which will be a nice kill here. The Devastator warship just moving through to the base area here. There are two rocket squads in there, but again, it's going to take a long time to actually destroy that Devastator warship. These Mammoth tanks will be dropping this base over here, so that's very nice. Meanwhile, Unleash has some more rail weaponry tanks coming over here. Space selling up a lot of his base over here. So there you go, that Devastator warship is still actually doing damage because he's just having a hard time shooting it down. It is now under attack and he's starting to do some damage to it now. He could target the upgraded power plants just to cause Unleash some problems. He will be firing at the infantry, killing them almost instantaneously. These tanks might actually link up with one another and Space will sell this up. He's going to consolidate in the middle area, which he's going for a hexapod as well. So there you go, this game here, on neither side able to really capitalize. He will finally get rid of that. The airfield was destroyed. Space not giving out any more orders. Not that he really could have achieved too much more. That Devastator warship is down. Zone trooper. Yeah, he's got a fair chunk of them. Some other scattered infantry in them as well. MCV is hiding down here now. He might want to make a move for this field. Oh, he's got a surveyor to do it for him. I think it's just to make sure that his MCV... Because Space would never look for it down here because there's no Tiberium. Normally, you'd find the MCV near Tiberium somewhere. But not in this case here. He's hiding it down there. He's managed to save four of his tripods, which is very well done. And he's got a hexapod out now. And he's actually going to move. He doesn't have the power to do this. I'm assuming he's upgrading his reactors. But it doesn't look like any of them actually going through. Maybe he's having some money. There we go. He did. He upgraded one of them now. So he's got enough power to power this area here. These tanks now are just looking for bases to destroy. The hammerheads are here. They can defend the armor. The problem is the armor needed to get rid of these plasma missile batteries because the hammerheads will be absolutely obliterated by them. It's not cost effective to engage them. He'll barely manage to destroy that one without losing half of his hammerheads, and he can't do that. Again, building some mechapedes, obviously for hammerhead defense here, mechapedes are great because it's really difficult to target the heads, and of course once you're in range, the disc destruction will just absolutely smash the hammerheads. Another screen unit which is very powerful against the air. And you can see it's already loaded with disc. It doesn't have anything hard pointed in the hexapod though, which is a bit of a problem. We have battle marker up here. So we have disintegrator squads. They will be engaging this tank force, and the railguns might be able to overwhelm this eventually, but he will lose both, or maybe three predators. Three predators will go down. There's more coming now. Yeah, this is not gonna work. These mammoth tanks are gonna get cornered by disintegrators, and they're gonna be pushed up against the side of the map. This is gonna be a good victory here for space. He should be able to make it count. He's going to pick off that back mammoth tank, that's for sure. They're actually still going quite a lot. Meanwhile, hammerheads are over here. They're trying to do something. They're trying to herd this around. And they're going to push these guys here into the corner space. Yeah, there we go. He's starting to clean them up now. And yeah, these mammoth tanks are not going to get anything done. That's very unfortunate. Meanwhile, Mechapede will get sniped. Oh, shard launches. Watch out for that. Those hammerheads in big trouble. The mammoth tanks did get completely overwhelmed over there. Now Unleash is just down to his hammerheads. He does have a base over here with a crane, and he is constructing something. It's also from his MCV, so apparently he's got the money for that. Now the hexapod is not hard pointed, so he can't actually fire at the hammerheads, and he's gonna phase, but that means he could have moved the corruptors close enough to phase range as well. Oh, he could snipe this down right now. He's gonna snipe down the drone platform. When it lands, it's very, very, very vulnerable. I've won a lot of games where the squid player has pushed by sniping the drone as it lands with hammerheads. As they try to land, it is extremely vulnerable for about 3 or 4 seconds while it's landing, because the zone troopers can actually fire at it because it counts as a ground unit. And it's also in its packed up mode. So, wow, does he have a gravity? He does not have a gravity stabilizer. The scan comes down. There is two plasma missile batteries. The rear of this base is extremely vulnerable. He's going to have to defend that with mobile AA if Unleash is looking for a hole, because you can see his scan, and he's going to go around, I think. Oh, he's going to watch out. He's going to try to overwhelm those defenses. I don't think so. He's going to come in. He's going to use that. That's a very good decoy there, by the way. He's going to go for a power run. He gets... Oh, no, he's not. He hasn't got the power. The power goes down now. Oh, look at all the hammerheads. The hammerheads took a real big pounding. Oh, that was really hard. I can see what he was trying to do there. Five remain. But he was trying to snipe down the power, but the power micro was insane by space there to keep those base defenses online for such a long time. And then the mech is shooting down quite a few. He can upgrade this reactor because he does have... There we go. Oh, no. No, yeah, he does have a nerve center, so you can upgrade that reactor. He's going to need it, because without the upgrade, he's not going to be able to power his base defenses. Meanwhile, a Marv is now coming down. Unleash is looking like he's in a good position now. Again, not upgrading this reactor. I think Space, is he aware that he has one right there and he can upgrade it? So he's still continuing to produce these corruptors. Battle marker over here. Oh, he does actually have a power plant over here as well, defended by two plasma missile batteries. So there you go. He could upgrade both of those and he would be absolutely fine on power. Obviously, every structure that he loses is going to be really bad. Oh my god, the Marv is going to come out just in time, but these tripods could bum rush it. Oh, what are you doing, Space? I think he realized just then. Oh no, not quite. There's actually no garrisons in it as well, which means it's really weak. But here comes the hammerheads. This is going to be a critical engagement right now. That then the hammerheads are trying to focus down the mechas. They will get one mechapede. We got heroic zone troopers, but oh man, he's losing. Oh no, heroic rocket squad, sorry. He's losing these hammerheads here. Will he be able to get the Marv? The tripods are falling. The Marv is not quite dead. He's got two more of these bad boys left. He's trying to focus down this last one. If he gets this, this is probably going to be the game, and he will save the Marv. Unfortunately, that mechapede just drifting in the background there, not good enough. I mean, he needed to be a bit more forward. Elite, by the way, that's nice. I would imagine he's very close to going heroic, but yeah, oops, what am I doing? I haven't got the HUD back on. What's happening over here? The hexapod is over here. We'll find these structures. Does he have EMP grenades? No, he does not. So these power plants are important to Unleash, so he has to rebuild those ones. He's gonna lose his tier 2 as well. He could he may require that for the coming battle. But meanwhile, Space not repairing the mechapede. He still hasn't upgraded these reactors. I think he's a bit divided right now. He doesn't really need to micro this hexapod. There's nothing really to micro it against. He could use his corruptors to quickly just snipe down this grenade squad. MCV still hiding in the corner there. This is a problem. Oh no, he's taking these husks. Oh, that's bad. And the Marv now has, what do we got into it? We got two rails and two engineers, so able to get some repairs there. This mechapede is here. Oh, is he in range? Is he going to go heroic? He will snipe that one down. Will he get one more? Oh my god, he's got heroic. He got a heroic mechapede. Oh my god, heroic mechapede master leaf right now. He's shaking his fist. It's like, that's supposed to be me doing that. But no, he's got the, that is insane. Look at that. Holy crap. Dat double A. I think he's going to actually find, he can't engage that. The mechapede is self-healing as well, which means he's going to reclaim all his health. And there's two more, there's three more mechapedes here now. This is a problem, Space. He sold off the AA batteries, yet he still hasn't upgraded. his power plant. I'm not sure if it must just have gone straight over his head there. But Unleashed is consolidated in the space of the Nav. He does have a Marv, but the Marv is so badly damaged right now that if it tries to engage the Hexapod, it's going to be destroyed. But the Hexapod has absolutely no garrisons, and with no portal, he can't garrison it with anything. So that's a problem. A few buildings left over there. But yeah, the Hammerhead's now coming around, and I think he might have to go for Shard Mecha because he doesn't need any more Disc Mecha because, yeah, there's only four Hammerheads left. I'm not even sure if he has any Zone Troopers. That one's empty. That one's got rifles. That one's got rifles. And that one has a Zone Trooper. So only one of them has a Zone Trooper in it. That Engineer making his way up the top there, by the way. I'm not sure where he's going to be going. But the Hexapod is engaging here, and he will be trying to destroy these units again. These Mechapedes. I'm not sure that's a good idea. Mechapedes aren't really a frontal force unit, but that is so much disc right there, especially with the heroic one. And he does have a lot of Shard Mecha there, so he is going for a lot of Shard Mecha. But here comes the tripods for the rush. They are rushing the Hexapod, and they will EMP it. But he needs to use these Mechapedes. He's gonna have to use these Mechapedes to fight tripods. He's going to have to try to destroy them. He destroyed one at the Warfactory. He should be able to get another one here. He is going to get another one. That's nice work. Two more fall. That means the Hexapod is going to power back up again. These railgun weapons causing problems. The heroic one is in there. Does he get that last tripod? No, he's not quite getting that. The discs, even with heroic, are quite not doing enough damage here. But I think he will finally pop it. He does pop it. And these guys moving through here, the Hexapod pretty badly damaged. The Corruptor's now coming back to heal it. But these Mechapedes actually tearing through the base, not being able to be stopped. Unleashed not quick enough. He has no fast attack units left, which means he's having problems. They're just running around this base area and destroying everything. This is a very serious problem here right now, and he's going to lose all of his structures here. The Marv is still here. I think it might not actually be okay because the Hexapod, to be honest, space could just destroy these structures and then evacuate this area. It's not necessary for him to be here. I'm not sure if he's going to be able to identify this. He's trying to destroy the Marv. The Mechapedes are trying to destroy the Marv as well. It might be better to destroy the railgun tanks because they're a lot less health. And they'll be a lot quicker to kill. Meanwhile, what's happening? There's an engineer. Oh my god, the engineer is going towards that Hexapod facility. Meanwhile, the Hexapod is going to go through this area here. Unleashed has not realized it. It's still on the move. I can see it on the radar. And he loses that. He's down to an MCV, I believe. He does have an insurance policy over here. And he's going to try to take the Warp Chasm. That's Space's last production structure. Space has $3,500. He wasn't producing anything. I'm not sure why. The Marv is dead, though. He has killed the Marv. The Heroic Mechapede still lives. What is he going to do? He puts down a portal. Oh my god, he's going to try to cap him out. He's going to try to cap him out of this game. He needs to get those Mechapedes. He needs to get the Mechapedes back to base. The Mechapedes are actually not going back to base. They're going down here. Oh my god. It doesn't matter if you destroy the MCV. It does not matter. He's got structures over here. You need to destroy these structures first. Space is making a critical error right now. I'm not sure if he realizes this. But, I mean, oh no, I don't know about this. This is not good. He's pumping out engineers. He can't. He's got to sell his base off. Oh my god, what's he going to do? This is, I don't know. And these harvesters, he needs to move the harvesters somewhere where, to trick Unleash to think where his base is. He's going to move them down to the north. The MCV is actually probably going to be destroyed eventually. These Corruptors actually need to shoot at it because they can do a lot of damage to it. There is one power plant over here. Does Unleash know about this? Does he know that that power plant is there? This is getting way too close. $7,500 to space. Does he know about that power plant? No, he does not know about the power plant. He doesn't know it's there. He does not know it's there. He lost his MCV. He's got an insurance policy down. He's sold off the surveyor. He's got a power plant remaining. That's all he's got left. It's just a power plant. Both sides have just a power plant, and they don't know where it is. Neither side knows where each other's power plant is. Neither side can refine, but Unleash has three spikes, which means he can actually produce units. But the Mechapedes are here, and they will stop this from going down. But Unleash knows exactly where the last structure is now. This is a problem. The Hexapod is elite. What is going on here now? He's got another engineer over here. Unleash has, I don't know where he's pulling these engineers from, but he's got one. That's right. He's got a portal. What am I doing? He's building as many engineers as he possibly can. Now, Space, if he loses this game, I'm never going to be able to talk to Space again. If he loses this game, he shouldn't really lose this game. He's got these mechas. These engineers shouldn't really count. You can't, if you're in a game where you have one building left, you cannot leave it undefended. Okay? Otherwise, a walking engineer is going to steal your game. And he's actually going to be able to destroy these now. That Heroic Mechapede, he's trying to switch it out, actually, to Shard Mecha. He could force the other Mechapede to destroy its segments if he wanted to, but he's not going to risk that. And he's going to take that out, and unfortunately, that's not going to be the end of the game. Two Corruptors and Buzzers are guarding this. Nice work there. What has Unleash got? He's got a tripod. Oh my god, he reclaimed a tripod with one of his engineers. oh my god, if the tripod comes up here, he could destroy everything, and he could take it out. There you go, he snipes one engineer down. He knows what's going on, so Space, very intelligent here, but Unleash at the same time, he's got this ace in the hole right now. If he gets over there with this tripod, he can destroy both of those corruptors, and he can take out that before he loses his last power plant. Space does not know where that is. He's got no idea where it is. He's sending his harvesters out to scout. Look, harvesters there. He's split. That's actually a really good idea. These harvesters have absolutely no value right now other than to draw fire and scout. And he's sending them out to all corners of the map, trying to find where Unleashed is hiding. He does have both his spikes. He hasn't yet hit silos, which means he doesn't have a lot of money, obviously. So when the spikes stop generating money, he'll actually have no... And he gets Space spots it. Space must be aware of this at the moment. He would have got a harvester who's under attack message. He kills another engineer. Does he not realize that this is here? He's got... Hey, the Mechapedes are going to find it. He's going to find the last building. Oh my god, this is going to be insane. I'm going to have to do split screen here. Oh my god, I've got the power plant drawn up. Oh, the power plant here. Look at the reactor in the bottom right hand side. Who is going to win? Unleashed is firing. Oh my god. Oh no. Space. I can forgive you for that, Space, because you did defend your power plant against engineer harassment, and oh my god, that... if it was a fraction of a second later, Space would have won. That whole game, that 30-minute game, was decided by about a quarter of a second, or a fraction of a second there. 29 minutes, 50 seconds. No wonder it's got so many wubs on it. But, that was insane. 202,000 to Unleash, 184,000 to Space. There's about 16, 17, 18,000 in favor of Unleashed UA, but in a half an hour game, it's not enough to make a difference. Space there, what can I say about these guys? Unleashed had a pretty solid game. He let himself get worked over a bit, but you can see the experience of that late game kicked in. Space did a pretty good job of the late game, actually. And again, both sides made very good decisions in that game there. But at the end of the day, it was just the flip of the coin at the end, who had the unit in the right position. And if Unleash had taken an extra, like I said, if any of those guys had taken an extra fraction of a second, the game would have been in the other person's favor there. But that was amazing. That was insane. That was a great game. You guys discuss about that one in the comments. But anyway, I'll leave it at that for the time being. I'm Green Zero, and I'll catch you all in the next video.